صلى على محمد وآل محمد.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.
ثانيا يغفر الله لكم.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.
ثالث على حب عقيدة بني هاشم سيدة زينب عليه السلام رحمه الله من يقال ثالث بعد أصواتكم.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا أبي القاسم محمد.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.
وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين. صلى الله عليك يا سيدي يا أبا عبد الله وعلى المستشهدين بين يديك. يا ليتنا كنا معكم سادتي فنفوز فوزا عظيما. روي عن إمامنا وسيدنا علي بن الحسين زين العابدين عليه السلام أنه قال لعمته زينب عليها السلام: عمه، أنت بحمد الله عالمة غير معلمة وفهمة غير مفهمة. Imam Zain al-Abidin, salam Allah alayh, in this statement he said and addressed his aunt Amma alayhi salam, Zainab. He said, Amma anti bihamdillahi alimatun ghayr mu'allama. You are, by the grace of Allah ta'ala, a knowledgeable scholar without being taught. وَفَهِمَةٌ غَيْر مُفَهَّمَةٌ. And you are smart without being given wisdom. This is a very important statement and hadith. I would like in this few minutes, inshallah, few minutes, I would like to shed some light on the knowledge of Sayyidah Zainab alayhi salam and the importance of knowledge in our society, especially for women. And you may ask me, why women? Because as Imam Khomeini Allah said, the woman, the mothers, just like the Quran. Quran teaches people. The book of upbringing, the book of tarbiyah. So the women, they have same role. So can you imagine a woman who does not have knowledge, proper knowledge? Yes, mashallah, we have most of the girls, most of the women, they are well-educated. And they have maybe highest levels of degree, but the problem when they have any issue, social issue, they have spiritual issue, they don't know what to do. Now, imagine there are many wives, they don't know how to deal with the mother-in-law. They don't know how to deal with sister-in-law. Why? Because they didn't teach. Nobody taught them in the university or the school about these issues. How to deal with the family of her husband? There are many issues. Yes, we think these issues are so trivial, but the consequence of these issues will destroy the family and destroy the society, the whole society. So that's why it's very important to have knowledge. But the problem is how to acquire this knowledge. Sometimes we read books, and that's very good, because you cannot acquire knowledge without reading books. We have people, they study online now, but most of the schools, they don't accept this degree. It's not accredited by most of the colleges or schools, because knowledge has to be acquired from a scholar, from a proper teacher. That's very important. If you read book and you have some issues, you have to ask directly. You have to ask. So, in Islam, I'm talking about Islam, Islamic knowledge. In Islam, it's very important to have Islamic proper knowledge. So not by listening to the speakers, because I am not giving you the real knowledge of Allah Azza wa Jal. Yes, this is my limited, because I am limited, so I can give you something that I understand. Maybe some alim else, some scholar else, he has another opinion, another view. That's why you see the differences between the scholars and maraji. Many people, they ask me why we have these differences now. Some ulama, they say this music is halal, for example. Others, they say no, haram. Of course, most of them, all of them, they say haram. So that's very important. Keep this in mind. All of them, they say music is haram. Yes. But we have to know what kind of music. You have to know that the details. I'm not talking about this now. But anyway, so we have these differences. That is the nature of our mind. The nature of human being, we have differences. But the problem is when we have to use this knowledge. Sometimes I have knowledge. Allah Ta'ala mentioned about Bani Israel, about the children of Israel. They say, مَثَلِ الَّذِينَ حُمِّلُوا التَّوْرَاةِ كَمَثَلِ الْحِمَارِ يَحْمِلُوا أَسْفَارًا. Himar, donkey. If you try, imagine a donkey and you put some books on his back, so what's the difference? Same thing. Some people, they have knowledge, and they have, mashallah, 20 years, they spend 20 years studying. But when it comes to any problem, very, you know, small issues in their daily life, they don't know how to do with, how to deal with these problems. They don't know. So can you imagine some psychologists, they have problems, spiritual problems. Some social, they have problems. Some doctors, they have problems. Don't we have doctors now, they smoke, for example, but they know it's, you know, smoking is not good. So, but they smoke. Don't we have doctors who drink alcohol? A'udhu billah. But they know the consequence of this act. But they do. Why? Because it becomes like a habit. Out of habit. They don't have willpower. Irada. So how to establish irada from Zainab alayhi salam? This night, the night of Sayyidina Zainab alayhi salam, in Arabic we call the mountain of patience. Jabal al-Sabr. The mountain of patience. Alayhi salam. Zainab alayhi salam, we can talk about too many aspects of her life, but I'm not going to expand the topic. So I will talk about the spirituality of Zainab alayhi salam. That's very important. That essence for everyone of us. If you don't have spirituality, believe me, you will not be succeed in your life. Why? Because in any problem, in any difficulty. So, what is the solution? The solution to connect yourself with the unlimited power, Allah Azza wa Jal. If you don't have this ability to connect yourself in any time, so then you will see that many, many psychological problems now, people, they suffer from these problems. They refer to the pills instead of referring to Allah Azza wa Jal. Zainab alayhi salam, and I'm talking about Zainab alayhi salam. Imagine a woman, she lost about 17 of her family members. And she came to the courtyard of the tyranny of Ubaydillah ibn Ziyad in Kufa, the ruler of Kufa. When she came in, he addressed her directly. Alhamdulillah alladhi fadahakum wa qatalakum. Thanks God that he killed you and your brothers. Wa akdhaba ahduthatakum. She replied immediately. Alhamdulillah, الذي أكرمنا. Allah Ta'ala has honored us with Muhammad al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Allah sallallahu
alayhi wa sallam. Tatheera, purified us from any kind of then sins. إِنَّمَا يُفْتَضَحُ الْفَاجِرُ وَهُوَ غَيْرُنَا يَعْدُوَ اللَّهُ or the enemy of Allah Ta'ala. Can you imagine a woman surrounded by thousands of soldiers with thousands of swords and she had this courage and she lost her father, her brother and her, you know, family members 2 days ago before this incident in Kufa. So she changed the situation of weakness in Kufa to the state of, you know, strength and quwwa and power. And same thing in Sham, in Syria, when she went to Yazid ibn Muawiyah, also same thing. She gave a long speech in the quarter of Yazid, or in the mosque of Sham, called Masjid al-Amawi. She gave a long speech and she mentioned everything, because people of Sham at that time, they know nothing about Ahlul Bayt, they hate Ahlul Bayt. So she came and she mentioned the name of Rasulullah and the name of Khadija and the name of all the bounties and blessing of Allah Ta'ala upon Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. She mentioned all these things in her khutbah. Then she changed the audience. In that session, she made them cry because of the tragedy of Karbala. Can you imagine this? Why? Because Zainab alayhi salam, she has this spirituality. That's why the historians say, you know, say that in the night of Ashura 11, yani the day of Ashura night, Imam Zain al-Abidin, he saw Zainab alayhi salam was praying while she's sitting down. He said, "Why, O Amma?" He said, "Because I'm so weak. After 3 days, I didn't eat anything. 3 days, I didn't drink anything." She used to pray Salatul Layl, not the wajib prayer. We have some people, they skip their prayer, the wajib prayer, or they delay the wajib prayer because they are busy. Zainab alayhi salam, she didn't skip the mustahab, the recommended prayer. Even in this very hard night, the night of 11, right after the Imam Hussein alayhi salam tragedy, and she spent the whole night with children, with the orphan, salamullah alayha. The historian mentioned that there were about 20 or 30 kids in the land, in the plain of Karbala. She used to go from the river of Al-Alaqami, from this side and that side. So 20 or more than 20 orphans in Karbala, and all of them, they say, "Oh Amma, Ayna Abi, where is my dad? Oh Amma, Ayna, where is my uncle?" So, see the patience of Zainab alayhi salam. We need this patience, sisters, especially sisters. Another thing, another lesson from Zainab alayhi salam, they say, there is a saying said that the word mighty, more mighty than sword. That's very important. In Arabic, we say, Al-Ayn Aqwa Min Al-Mikhraz. So, that's why you have to put this in your mind, sisters, brothers, because every time, don't think our enemies, they have power, they have money, they have everything. They have media when we have nothing. No, we have Allah Azza wa Jal. We have our faith, our iman. So we don't have underestimate our faith. If you have, just today I was receiving a question from one of the, you know, mu'mineen. He said, "Why we have to know ourselves?" Good question. Why we have to know ourselves? What's the benefit of that? So I replied in short, in a quick answer. We have to know ourselves because in this materialistic life or system, they put an effort, what? And they study every phenomenon in this world to know what's going on. but they don't know themselves. I said that this human being nowadays, they went to the moon, mashallah. They have this ability, they have this power, they have, mashallah, the technology. But they fail to visit their neighbor. They fail to visit their neighbor because they don't have faith. Because faith enlightens the heart, enlightens the mind, and you can reach Allah Azza wa Jalla through your nafs, your soul. مَنْ عَرَفَ نَفْسَهُ فَقَدْ عَرَفَ رَبَّهُ. This is the answer. If you know yourself, then you will know your Lord, Allah Azza wa Jalla. But if you have no idea about yourself, you live 20, 30, 40, 50 years in this life without knowing the purpose, without knowing anything, then you will lose yourself. الَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ وَأَهْلِيهِمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. That's very important. So we have to know from, because the point that we start from this point, if you don't know yourself, it's very hard, of course, very hard. Now we can talk about others, hours. That's why when we get together in our Sahara, for example, we talk about others, no problem. But if someone asks you, imagine this, if someone asks you, tell me about yourself, you know nothing. You can speak maybe 5 minutes. That's it. But you have to think about this issue. You have to know yourself. مَنْ عَرَفَ نَفْسَهُ رَحِمَ اللَّهُ مَنْ عَرَفَ مِنْ أَيْنِ وَفِي أَيْنِ وَإِلَىٰ أَيْنِ. These three questions, very important question. Where I came from and what I'm doing now and where I'm going to. وَفِي أَيْنِ وَإِلَىٰ أَيْنِ. Because we have beginning and we have an end. We have to know the beginning, we have to know the end. We have to know what to do between these two points. Very important. Million of people, more than a billion of people, they know nothing. They live, they survive just to eat and drink and sleep and that's it. And fulfill their desires, physical desires. But the mu'mineen, those who know what to do, just like Zainab al-Aqil alayhi salam, they have tranquility in their life. Even at the time of hardship, Zainab alayhi salam in the day of Ashura, after Ashura, in the way to Syria, Sham, you know, always she tried to spread the message of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, of Allah azza wa jal. She didn't say, okay, why we have to suffer, why we have to pay the price, why? So that just like many people now, nowadays. They say, why we are Muslim, for example, why we have to wear hijab? At the summer time, it's very hard for women to wear hijab. Keep complaining, Zainab alayhi salam, and the all Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. What did she say? Zainab alayhi salam, she said, "Ma ra'ayt illa jamila." And the courtyard of Ibn Ziyad, she said a beautiful statement, and I would like every one of you to memorize this statement. "Ma ra'aytu illa jamila." Ibn Ziyad asked Zainab alayhi salam, "Okay, can you explain to me? Can you describe the tragedy, the massacre of Karbala?" She said, "Ma, I didn't see anything except the beauty. Ma ra'ayt illa jamila." Can you imagine this? More than 100 martyrs in the land of Karbala, and she said, I didn't see anything except beauty. This is the satisfaction. This is the rida. If I want to explain the meaning of rida, radiyallahu anhum wa radu an, believe me, I didn't find, you know, better than this statement of Zainab alayhi salam. Ma ra'aytu illa jamila. I'm satisfying with Allah Azza wa Jalla, that's it. Allah Ta'ala is, you know, sufficient for me. So I don't care about all these problems. Yes, to see someone just like Yusuf alayhi salam. Yusuf, he was in prison. Also, Yusuf, he didn't say, prison is good or beautiful. No, nobody said this. Even the Anbiya, the Prophet of the Ummah. But he said, Rabbi sijnu ahabbu ilay. I like the prison if you are satisfied with me. The prison becomes, you know, better than any palace in this, you know, world. Why? Because you are satisfied with me. This is my criteria. Otherwise, I don't care. So although this, the prison is not good, although killing your family is not good, there is no beauty here. But she said, "Ma ra'ayt illa jamila," because of her spirituality, salamullah alayha. We need brothers and sisters in this month of Rajab, in the month of Sha'ban, in the month of Ramadan, inshallah. May Allah Ta'ala give us, prolong your life all to receive Ramadan and Mubarak with health, inshallah, with Iman. So we need this to establish this spirituality step by step. It doesn't come at once. It's very hard. Step by step, bit by bit. When they try to taste the dua, when they try to taste 2 rak'ah at the midnight, 2 rak'ah only, not 11 rak'ah. We don't want to say what salat al-layl. So 2 rak'ah. Recite several ayat of the Quran. Choose some ayat that you become influenced by this ayat. That's very important. While you are driving, you're sitting, that's very important. I'm not going to take more time. I think that's enough, inshallah, for the English speakers, our speaking, the audience. Inshallah, may Allah Azza wa Jal grant us the ziyarah of Zainab alayhi salam. I remember one of the friends in Syria, he used to travel to some countries in the West at that 20 years ago. So after traveling to the West, after several months, he came back to Syria at that time. So one of our friends, he asked him, why are you coming back? He said, believe me, one time I visit the shrine of Sayyidina Zainab alayhi salam, in my eyes, better than the whole world. One ziyarah, if I go to the shrine of Sayyidina Zainab alayhi salam, and I kiss the shrine, the door of Sayyidina Zainab alayhi salam, and because those people, they have different criteria. We measure things depend on what? On money or our, you know, physical things or materialistic things. But the mu'mineen, the believer, they measure things. If you go, inshallah, Hajj al-Awra next week, inshallah, she will talk about the ziyarah of Ahlul Bayt Ramallah in Iraq. You see the sweetness of these things in your life. And you see the barakah of these things. That's very important. Believe me, you know, if you spend thousands of dollars, it's worth it. Worth it. Because you cannot measure, you know, you cannot say, you know, yeah, it's too expensive to pay 6,000 to make Hajj. No, don't say this. Wallahi, if you spend thousands of dollars, you know, 100,000 of dollars, it's worth it because of the barakah and the spirituality of these a'mal. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to grant us the ziyarah of Sayyidina Zainab alayhi salam in the city of Sham, Syria. We ask Allah Ta'ala Azza wa Jal to grant us all the shafa'ah, the intercession of Zainab alayhi salam. Walhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. صلوا على محمد وآل الطاهرين
الله صلي على محمد وآله